February is Heart Awareness Month, so it's a good time to talk about your microbiome, which can have a huge impact on your health.
Erin Judge is a registered dietitian, nutritionist. She's got some tips for us today. First off, what is your microbiome?
Your microbiome is the makeup of microbes in your gut. So that includes bacteria, fungi, viruses, all of that in your gut. There's over like 3 trillion bacteria living there. That's what we know the most about.
They're not paying rent?
They are doing a lot for our bodies, though. Okay. So they do play a beneficial role in nutrient absorption. So it's their major role, digestion. Okay. Know that. They also play a role in regulating our hormones, our mood. They play a role in mental health.
Okay.
And inflammation.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, I have heard the healthier your gut is, the more likely you are to not get sick. Like, it helps keep your whole body well. So what are some things that we need? You said start off with good fiber, like a prebiotic, probiotic kind of situation. Tell us about that.
Yeah. So our bacteria have to be healthy to do their jobs, just like us, right? And to get healthy, they have to eat something. So their main food source is the prebiotic fiber.
Okay.
So fiber is a prebiotic. It is only found in plants. So we find fiber through a plant-rich, plant-based diet that includes colorful fruits and vegetables, our grains, our legumes, nuts, seeds, all of the different plants that we have.
Okay.
So as we eat a variety of plants, our microbes thrive, and they're actually more diverse, doing their job much better.
And the more of this that you eat and the less processed food, so the bad bacteria is going away, the good bacteria is getting fed.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So our processed food, the problem with it is that it doesn't have fiber. And so we don't have anything to feed our gut bacteria with. And so when we're eating more processed foods, we're not including much of these. So this looks like what, you know, a day of fiber would look like.
Whoa.
So it's really hard
this
to
get this. This is all in a day?
Yeah. You definitely can if you're intentional. But it's not as easy with our schedules, how busy we are with our food system.
Right.
So that's where a fiber supplement, so a prebiotic supplement, could come into handy.
You've got a couple here. The thing that I get worried about, is this going to hurt your stomach? Like, are you going to be doubled over if you're doing this?
It can and it can't. So this is what we have to know. There are two types of fiber.
That one's
soluble,
all for you, Joe.
And insoluble.
Regular girl.
My favorite.
Yes.
So our soluble fiber, which is found in most of our legumes and our grains, it does not cause like extra gas or bloating. It helps to kind of regulate the flow of digestion.
Gotcha.
Our insoluble fiber is found in the structure of our plants, and a lot of insoluble fiber can actually cause a little bit of gas.
Okay.
So when we're looking for a supplement, you want a soluble fiber supplement.
Soluble.
Soluble.
Got it.
My favorite, because we have science now, so if you think about, you know, 20 years ago, a fiber supplement was yellow. It was cloudy, probably didn't taste very good.
Right.
But sun fiber, which is regulated as a fiber supplement that is completely odorless, colorless, so it dissolves,
and
flavorless.
Excellent.
So you can stir it into your water in the morning. You could put it into a smoothie with all of your other gut-loving plants. You can incorporate it into your diet like you're already using.
Well, that we need. No, I'm saying we need on your website.
JudgeNutrition.com, or you can find me on Instagram at ErinJudge.rd.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
This is awesome. All right, we're gonna eat all this. We'll be right back.
Have a good day, Erin.